Hello folks, this is Miguel Borba with Made to Cut Golf, Remastered Edition. Here's a second video on the list of videos going over the functionality of the game and how to play. You're looking at the fourth hole at Bethpage Black State Park's Black Course, which Lucas Glover chose as his favorite hole, favorite number four, hole number four. And I'm going to show an example of how the game is played with an actual card, golfer. So you can see how the rolls are made and how you determine where the shot lands and all that good stuff. Let's take a look at Happy Gilmore, who's my celebrity golfer. And you can see on the card, it's a busy looking card, but the shot that you take on the course are very easy to follow when it comes to taking your shot and the spray and the roll. And then the short game is a very, very easy quick little roll to see how well his short game shot was. And then when it comes to putting, you have gimme 4 feet all the way up to 21 feet and higher. So if you look at Happy Gilmore, which is just a par five, so you can see that out to 300 yards, you know, this hole is 517 yards long from the tee box. So you can see that Happy can carry his driver 300 yards. And if you look at these percentages, anything above 50 means that the golfer is a little bit better than average on that shot. Anything below 50 means he's a little bit worse than average on that shot to execute. It's basically executing a good versus a poor shot. So he's going to target a 300-yard carry, and he has a 48% chance of making a good shot, hitting a good shot. And then his spray, the parentheses here is whenever you're taking a shot off the tee, you use the parentheses instead of the spray, which would be a shot off the fairway or first cut while on the course. Of course, rough bunker and other will have a different set of numbers. But let's go back to setting up this shot. So I'm going to show you the Dice app or webpage that I like to use for this game. It's called dice.clockworkmod.com. If you go there, you find a page that looks like this. And on the first line, I change that to a D100 roll. But always, on every roll, you always subtract one from the result. And so for his percentage roll, he's going to have a D100 minus one to create numbers from 00 through 99. And then to determine where his ball sprayed, I'm going to put a dice for the spray. And he could tell from here, off the tee with his driver, he's a 20 spray. So the 20 already defaults, so it's D20 minus 1. And that the first dice here determines spray right and left. And now I'm going to add a second dice to determine forward and back, which you use the same spray value. So that's also going to be minus 1. So there you have it. I'm ready to roll and get a percentage dice to compare it to the 48. And then the two 20 minus 1s will determine right and left scatter, and then whether the ball was hit poorly or not poorly, shorter or longer than the actual target landing spot. So let's set up the shot first. Looking at 300 yards for Happy Gilmore. Looks like This will be a good spot for him to try to land at. And now it's going to scatter perpendicular right or left, and then shorter or longer based on the dice roll. So let's see what happens. You simply hit roll, and you get all three rolls right here. The first roll is going to be the percentage dice, and you can see that from a 21, Happy hit a good shot. A 13 is a scatter. Odd numbers scatter left, even numbers scatter right. So a 13 simply means his ball went 13 yards left of the current target. So if I'm at 300, so it's 313 right there. And now I have to determine whether it landed shorter or longer. And that's the last dice, which is 11. Odd means you hit it shorter than normal. Even, you hit it longer than normal. So it's 11 yards short. That means if he's at 313, 11 yards is going to be 324, headed this direction. And just missed the edge of the bunker and into, I would call it the rough. So I will land it there. And now we have to determine the roll. On Happy's driver, you can see that when he takes a driver, it's going to roll 30 yards additionally after it lands. So it lands here in the rough, and it's going to roll forward along the line parallel to the shot line, 30 yards. So the way the game works is in the rough, it counts 2 yards per yard. I mean, 2 yard. It costs 2 yards every yard of rough on the roll. So 324 to about 331, that's about 7 yards. So that's 14 yards of the 30 to that point. And that means I have 16 yards left. That puts me at 331 plus 16 is 347. So you see that he hit a beautiful shot in the middle of the fairway. And I'll land it there. And now we just have to mark it with a marker in that spot. So now he's looking at his shot coming into the hole, the green, I mean, sorry. And you can see that the green, the pin is located in the back left corner. And let's see how far Happy has to shoot this. It's looking like about a 200-yard shot if he's going straight at the pin, which we all know with Happy Gilmore, he's always aggressive, so he is going for the flag stick. And it's 202 yards. So let's look at his card. Now he's on the fairway, taking a 200-yard shot, which is less than 210, but more than 190. So that means it's in the 210 range of column. He's going to have a 46% chance of making a good shot, and it sprays 18 right or left. More importantly, or just as important, it's going to have a roll of 16. So if he wants to land at 202, he's going to have to hit it to about 186, which would land him in the rough. That would be a perfect shot. It would land here and roll, but since you got about 4 yards of rough, that's 8 yards. I would target landing at about the 190 in the direction of the flag stick. So let's target landing there and see what happens. 190 is nice because it puts him in this D column instead of the 210. And now he has a much better chance of a shot, a good shot, and a much less scatter of only 13. A spray of 13 with a roll of 12. So I know that I might be short with the roll if I hit a perfect shot, but it's better to take the 69%. So he's going to do that. So the way that I do that is 13 scatter with a D100%. My D100 is already set. All I change is this, the 13. And now he's ready to roll a 50. Remember, he had a 69, so that's a good shot by Happy Gilmore. He had a scatter to the left because it's odd 5 of 5 yards, and he hit it flush, perfect distance. So let's go back to the course. He's going to go from 195 yards to the left, which lands there. And then we know that the roll is 12 yards, and it's 2 yards per rough. So here is about, so from 195 to 202. Is about 7, that's 14 yards. It's only going to roll 12, so it's going to come up short to 200. That's 10 times 2. Sorry, it's going to roll 6 yards, right? So 201 is where it lands. I mean, settles. So here you are. Let me take away that last one. Oops. So that's done. So Happy hits a nice shot. It is still in the rough. So now he's going to have a short game play to see if he can get up and down for par for birdie. This is his second shot on the par 5. So let's go to Happy's card. And now you look at the short game. He's in the rough. And the C and the F stand for a rough chip versus a rough flop. The way the short game works is when you determine the distance to the hole, if there's less green than the shot distance, then it requires a flop. So if he's shooting from back here, all this rough and a little bit of green, he would have to use a flop percentage to try to get up and down. But since he has a lot of green to work with, this is considered a chip. So if we look at his chipping game, he has a 46% chance out of the rough to give himself a chance for an up and down. Let's go to my dice. We could ignore these dice. All we're looking at is the top 100% dice. He's trying to get a 46% for a good chip. He does. He has a good chip. So now he simply has to make his gimme. And Happy Gilmore struggles with his short putting. Tap, tap, tap. He's looking at a 47% chance of tapping it in. Whenever you successfully hit a short game shot, you go to the gimme putt. Whenever you fail your short game shot, you go to the 21 and over putt. So you can see that it's a huge difference of whether you get up and down or not, whether you make a good chip shot or short game shot. So he has a 47%, he hit it. He has a 47% chance now to make his putt. Again, only look at the top number. He failed. Anytime you fail a putt, any of these putts, including the gimme, you do a gimme again. So now he's looking to tap in 2 putt for par. Failed again. This is interesting. When you roll a 99 in my game, that means you really screwed up that pitch. And he missed anyways. I mean, that stroke. He missed his putt anyways on this one. So he has a gimme again for bogey. Misses. Double bogey. Misses. Triple bogey. Happy Gilmore. True to form. Hits 2 beautiful shots. Makes a good chip. And then proceeds to 4 putt for a triple bogey. There you have it, folks. That's an example of how the game is played with a golfer, in this case Happy Gilmore, who triple bogeys the 4th hole at Bethpage Black. Please do me a favor and like the video and join the subscriber list so that I can grow the channel. But I'll be back with some more content shortly. Thank you.